In this video, we will discuss the pharmacotherapy of amoebiasis. Well, this is a diagram from our previous video in which I discussed the life cycle of intramuscular histolytica with a brief introduction and disease types. So, the therapeutic agents for amoebiasis are classified as luminal amoebicides, systemic amoebicides, and mixed amoebicides. First, let's talk about the luminal amoebicides. Well, luminal amoebicides act on the pharyngite in the lumen of the bowel. These agents do not absorb into the blood. Some get absorbed but do not show any systemic amoebicidal effect. Most of the amoebic cells remain in the intestine before and after invasive infection. So, it is important to get rid of these intestinal amoebas as well. Otherwise, the patient will be at risk for another case of disease. That is why luminal amoebicides are considered after treatment of invasive intestinal or extra-intestinal amoebic disease to stop the asymptomatic colonization of trophozoites in the intestinal lumen. Because systemic and mixed amoebicides are ineffective in eradicating cyst form, while luminal amoebicides are effective in this case. These agents include iodoquinol, diloxanide, furoate, and paromomycin. Paromomycin is an aminoglycoside antibiotic that does not absorb into the blood and is considered the most effective in this class. Iodoquinol and paromomycin are used in the US, while diloxanide, furoate is used in other countries. Next, we have the systemic amoebicides. Systemic amoebicides are effective against the amoebas in the intestinal wall and liver. These agents include chloroquine and dehydroemetine. Chloroquine is used in combination with metronidazole or instead of metronidazole in case of any restriction or intolerance on the use of metronidazole. Chloroquine is an antimalarial agent and is also effective in amoebiasis. It is the mostly used agent of this class and is effective against hepatic abscess but not useful for luminal amoebiasis. Dehydroemetine is an epicoc alkaloid with some toxicities like cardiotoxicity and neuromuscular weakness which limit its uses. The intramuscular form is preferred over the oral form because oral formulation causes irritation of the GI mucosa. Then we have the mixed amoebicides. Mixed amoebicides are effective against both systemic as well as luminal amoebas. These agents are rapidly absorbed into the bloodstream and transported to the site of action. Mixed amoebicides include the most widely used drug metronidazole, widely known as Flagyl, right? Metronidazole is the mixed amoebicide of choice for treating amoebic infections. It is also used to treat other diseases caused by other protozoans and anaerobic bacteria. The other agent in this class is tinidazole. Tinidazole is a second generation nitroimidazole, similar to metronidazole in the spectrum of activity and adverse effects. And with this, thanks for watching. Do like this video and subscribe. Bye.